At last I found it. We need to get to him somehow. Come on, hurry. This is it. Do you understand? This is the key. Is what I've been looking for. He is it!
It's a monster. I mean, look at it.
I know what he looks like, but I swear to you, he is not a threat.
All the more reason to kill him.
No, you have to let him take me back to my family.
What did your book say about it?
This book is a map designed to lead me here. It's showing me how I can reunite with my family. This is a treasure beyond anything I imagined, and this being is the key to it.
What? This thing? Are you expecting it to talk to you? Said.
He knows why I'm here. I think he is saying I don't have much time.
If it's that important to you.
Yes.
Mighty Antennas, there must be something that has been keeping people from finding a way inside the hand of fallen Adir for so long. All the tales of people who have been in this chamber have something in common. They were shocked by something.
much I can teach you. I can show you eternity. Your first battle was an initiation. The first lord I sent upon you was not expecting you to be his match. Later, you faced this one on the battlefield. You fight the Rogar because you perceive them to be your enemy. You fail to see their true nature, their true purpose, their true magnificence.
I didn't come here to talk.
You also defeated this lord and his minions. Look upon yourself, Harkon. You are an outcast, a pariah. You've been imprisoned, branded, forgotten. Than you would admit. I feel your anger. You lashed out, you brutalized and slaughtered. You are Rogar. You have no place in this world.
Face me!
You have done battle with every creature that crossed your path. You even slayed the last lord, leading the offensive on your citadel. The Rogar are no monsters. They're man's creation, the sons of men. They are born out of your anger, your fear, your shame. These are not demons, Harkon. They are mirrors, reflecting mankind back to itself.
You lie!
You have fended off all the Lord's attacks. Most impressive. Antennas says he will remove evil from humanity. These are the words of a child. How do you separate day from night? Death. Good cannot exist without evil.
You twist words to mean what you want them to mean.
And then you brought the battle to my door when you defeated my guardian. Your savagery feeds this war. motivation. He is full of hatred when he should be full of love. He believes he can rule with godlike power, but he is as flawed as any mortal. Why do you serve a man that hates you? A man that would see you rot in a dungeon for all of your days. The world is in flames, Harkon. Antanas cannot save it. No man can. Only a god can. Antanas' pride and destructive nature has brought me forth back into the world. You need me, Harkon. All of humanity needs me now. Let me help you. Look at Antanas. See him for what he is. Don't let him destroy you. You drew power from your enemies. You drank it. You are like them now. I will show you a way out. I will give you a gift, and with this gift, you can give me the soul of Antanas. With this gift, you can restore balance and peace. The choice is yours, Harkon.
Kesla, is it really you?
Hello, Harkin.
What's the meaning of this? Are you a deer?
No, Harkin. I'm not a god, but I'm not the man you think I am either.
Then tell me who you are.
The universe requires balance. I am the guardian of that balance. I do not serve Antanas or a deer. I am the true judge.
You brought me into this fight to create more violence and chaos. Why?
Your capacity for barbarism is equal to that of the Rogar Lords. Before you, Antanas' army was hopelessly outmatched. The Rogar Lords would have destroyed them with little effort. Then this world would have fallen into utter chaos.
What is this rune Adir gave me?
I never imagined a rune like this would exist. It holds a tremendous